everyone. My name is Ravi Prakash and welcome to the third class of Divisibility. Okay. So let's continue Divisibility and we'll do some questions here. What we studied in last videos, right? So let's do some questions now. Okay. Question is 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 written till 100 digits. Okay. Divided by 33. What is the remainder? Okay. So 1 2 1 2 1 2 written till 100 digits divided by 33. What is the remainder? Okay, fine. Now we have studied this, that 33 is a number. 33 is a number which on dividing by 10 square gives me a remainder of plus 1. Okay, this we know. That means 10 square means what? Making groups of 2, 2. Making groups of 2, 2. 2, 2. So sorry, right? So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 like this is written. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. These are 100 digits, right? Now making groups of 2, 2 now. So making groups of 2, 2. So groups of 2, 2. I can make these many groups, right? Each group will have 10, each group will have, right, like the last group will have nothing as common. So 1 by 33, remainder is plus 1 only. Now each group will have a multiple of 10 square as common, either 10 square or a multiple of 10 square. And we know that 10 square, 10 raised to 2k by 33, remainder will be plus 1 only. That means any multiple of 10 square divided by 33 will give me a remainder of plus 1. And each group will have multiple of 10 square. Right, so all will be what? Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. Okay, so how many groups are here? There are total 100 digits. There will be 50 groups of 2, 2. There will be 50 groups of 2, 2. So what is the resultant of all the groups? So all the groups have got plus sign. So add all the groups. So 12 into 50, right? There will be 50 groups of 12. Because there are 100 digits, they can form 50 groups of 2, 2. So 12 into 50 by 33. That is how much? That is 600 by 33 remainder. Now you can do it directly, but again, I'd like to use this concept. I can maximum shorten to 3 digits. Sorry, 2 digits, because 33 is made of a group of 2, 2. So 600 by 33, right? So again, making a group of 2, 2, and I can put a 0 here. So 0 by 33, remainder is 0 only, right? So this is like 0 only. I should write plus 1 because from here 10 raised to 0 will come as common, but 1 into 0 is 0 only, right? And 6 by 33 is 6 only. So what is the answer? Answer for this question is 6. So 6 is answer, right? 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, till 100 digits divided by 33, what is the remainder? Remainder is 6. Okay, so good question, right? Next one, we'll discuss next question. Next question is 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5 are written till 202 digits. Okay, sorry, till 200 digits. Okay, what is the remainder when this big number is divided by 7? Okay, so what is the remainder when this big number is divided by 7? Right. Now again, for 7 we know that, 10 cubed by 7 gives me a remainder of minus 1, and alternately I'll get 10 6 by 7 will give me a remainder of plus 1. So alternately I need to put plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1, right? But after making groups of 3 3, after making groups of 3 3. Okay, now listen carefully here. This, if I make groups of 3, 3 here, so 200 is not a multiple of 3. 200 is not a multiple of 3, right? And how to make groups? Groups should be always made from last, not from first, because counting is done from last only. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 1000, 1000, right? So groups has to be made from last, right? So if I write, if I complete this, so 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, so it will have like 33 groups, 33 into 2, 66. because each group has got 3 digits. So 200 by 3 is equal to 66. So I can make 66 such groups. Okay. 66 such groups of 345345. And like there are 66 such groups here. 66 such groups here. And 66 into 3 is 198. So it's still 2 digits left. So again in this chain 345345 then 3 then 4. That's it. That's it. Right. So this is 198 digits and this is 2 digits. 200 digits over. 200 digits over. Okay. So now I'll make groups of 3-3. So if I'll make groups of 3-3, see, it was earlier looking like it will become a group of 3-4-5-3-4-5. But it is actually the group is made from where? Last. So if you make a group of 3-3 from last, 5-3-4, 5-3-4, right, 5-3-4. So groups actually become for 5-3-4. Groups actually become for 5-3-4. Okay, 5-3-4, 5-3-4. So it's actually like this. It's actually like this, right? Now let's read it finally. Okay, so I hope you learned something, right? It's a good question because these are not multiple of 3. So it's like 534, like this 66 groups. Okay, 66 groups, each groups of 3 digits. So 198 digit over. Okay, so 198 digit over like this. And last will be left with what? Again 534. Again see 5435. See 435, then again 4, then again 3. So actually this segregation is like this. Two more digits. It becomes 100, right? So once you make groups of 33 now. So once you make groups of 33 now, you see. So there are total 66 groups of 3-3 digit and one group of 2 digit, right? So I can make it 3 digit by putting 10, right? Nothing will happen if I put 10 here, right? So you have 2 digits and 3 digits. So 198 plus 2, 200 digits, right? So this divided by 7, what is the remainder? Now, time to put plus 1 and minus 1, right? So now, very carefully you'll put plus 1 and minus 1, right? Why? Because in the first one, nothing is coming as common, right? First 3. So 1 by 7 remainder is plus 1 only. Then second one, 10 cube will come as common, right? So second group, 10 cube by 7 remainder is minus 1. Then from third one, 10 6 by 7 remainder is plus 1. So alternately it goes, right? Alternately it's like plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1 like this. So there are 66 groups. There are even number of groups, right? For 3-3 digit. So start with plus 1, it will end with minus 1. It will end with minus 1, right? That means if there are 66 groups, there are 33 groups of plus 1 and 33 groups of minus 1, right? That completely cancels, right? It's like, what is the result of this whole model? The result is, there are, if I add all the groups of 534, there are 534 into 33 and there are minus groups, right? Minus 534 again into 33. This whole cancel, it is 0. Now after minus 1, there will be plus 1. Like it's plus 34 here. Like it's plus 34 divided by 7 remainder. So what is the final answer? This becomes 0. So 34 by 7. What is the remainder? Remainder is 6. So 6 is the answer for this absolutely super question. Okay, 6 is the answer for this question. 345345345 written till 200 digits. Okay, what is the answer? Answer is 6. Sure, yeah, I think it's fine. Okay, now let's move to another concepts now. So we can just generalize it now for all the values now, right? So right now we know that the rules for we know divisibility rule for in this groups making. We have done 33, we have done 7, right? So now we can do for all other such numbers, right? Any new number I get. So see, basically 7, 10 cube, 7 is a number. So 10 cube by 7 gives a remainder of minus 1, right? So 10 cube is 1000, right? 10 cube is 1000. That means 1000 by 1001, okay, 1000 by 1001 will give me a remainder of minus 1. Now, what are factors of 1000? 1001. So 1001 can be written as 7 into 11 into 13, right? That means 1000 by 7, remainder is minus 1. That means 1000 by 13, remainder is minus 1. That means 1000 by 11, remainder is minus 1. So for rules are absolutely same, okay? Rules are same for 7, 11 and 13, okay? Similarly, for remainder to be plus 1, 1000 by 999, I'm just taking 1000 here, I can take 100 as well, I can take 10,000 as well, right? So these are most common numbers, that's why I'm taking 1000 here right now. So 1000 by 999, remainder is plus 1. Now what are factors for 39? So factors for, sorry, not 39, for 999 are what? So 999 is 37 into 27. Okay, that means 1000 by 37 also will give me a remainder of plus 1, because 1000 by 999 is giving me a remainder of plus 1 and 37 is a factor of 999, right? So it is plus 1. Also, 1000 by 27 will give me a remainder of plus 1. So here also I can write rules are same for 37 and 27. Both are getting plus 1, 7, 11, 13, all 3 are getting minus 1. Okay, so very important things we discussed here, says 37, 27, right, 7, 11, 13 like this. Okay, now, let's do some question, right, keep in mind that 37 and 27, right, we don't have to search for now. Okay, you know that when you see this number like 37, okay, so a very common number in quant, right, you'll face whenever you see such kind of question, 37, 27, 7, 11, 13, right, all are very point numbers, right? So 37 and 27 at 10 cube will gives me a remainder of minus 1. Okay, now let's do some question here. Question we can write. Seven four one is written till 300 digits. Okay, what is the remainder when this whole number is divided by 37? What is the remainder? This is the question. Again, a very good question, conceptual question, right? 741, 741, 741 till 300 digits is written. What is the remainder when this whole big number is divided by 37? Okay, now I know that what is 37, so I don't have to search for now. 37 is like 10 cube by 37 will give me a remainder of plus 1, right? We just did 10 cube by 999 gives me a remainder of plus 1 and 37 is a factor of 999. So 10 cube by 37 will give me a remainder of plus 1, right? Sure? Yeah. So 10 cube by 37 will give me a remainder of plus 1. Okay. So that means now, since it is first time plus 1, so it will always be plus 1 out, right? At every multiple of 10 cube. If I write 10 6, so 10 6 by 37 will also give me a remainder of plus 1 only, right? Because 10 cube into 10 cube. So 1 into 1 is 1 only. So if it is first time plus 1, it will always be plus 1, like 33. First time 10 is square by 33, remainder is plus 1. So at every multiple of 10 is square, it has to be plus 1 only. Same here, at every multiple of 10 cube, okay? At every multiple of 10 cube, 10 raised to 3k upon 37. That remainder has to be plus 1. So at every multiple of 10 cube, that remainder has to be plus 1 only. Okay. So now, I know that it is at 10 cube. I know that it is a 10 cube, right? So 10 cube means what? I'll make groups of 3, 3. So I'll make groups of 3, 3 and I'll observe that if I'll make groups of 3, 3, So here are absolutely 300 digits. So equal, right? No, there's a symmetry here. No issue will be caught, right? So like it's like 741, 741, 741, 741. It goes like 741, 741 like this, right? And here are 300 digits, 300 digits, right? Now, if I make groups of 3-3, I'll start making groups of 3-3 from last, right? Groups of 3-3 from last I'll make. Groups of 3-3. How many groups I can make? I can make 100 such groups. Okay, since there are 300 digits, so I can make 100 groups of 3-3. Now, from first 3, nothing will come as common. So, since it is plus 1 by 37, remainder is plus 1 only. Right. From second, 10 cube will come as common. So, again, it is plus 1. From third, always right. So, now 10 raised to 3k. At every multiple of 10 raised to 3k, that remainder by 37, remainder is plus 1 only. So, since I have taken groups of 3-3, so from each group of 3-3, either 10 cube will come as common or any multiple of 10 cube will come as common, right? So, since at all multiple of 10 cube, 37 gives a remainder of plus 1, so I can simply put all plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. Right, how many groups here? 100 groups. So 741 into 100 is the resultant of all the groups. This is bigger than 37. So again, divide by 37. Don't forget basics of remainder, right? Again, divide by 37. So 74,100 by 37. Now I can do it here manually. I can do manually, but I know that again, same thing. Since it is 3-digit number, since 37, for 37, I can make groups of 3-3. So I can maximum shorten this big number. I can shorten at last to 3-digit number. Instead it is 5-digit number. So again I'll make groups of 3-3. First group of 3-3, I'll put a 0 here. No issue. Right? So again, from here nothing will come as common. It is plus 1. It is also plus 1. At the back of the mind, you should always know that why it is plus 1. Because from last 3, nothing will come as common. So 1 by 37 will give me a remainder of plus 1 only. From next 3, 10 cube will come as common. So 10 cube by 37 will give me a remainder of plus 1 again, right? So now again, add both the groups, okay? So resultant of both the groups is what? 100 plus 74, 174. So 174 by 37 remainder. Now, since it is maximum now shortened to 3 digit, I can't further do it now, so I have to do it manually now, right? So 37 into 4 is 148. Or 37 into 5 is 185. It is minus 11. So remainder is minus 11. So 37 minus 11. What is the final answer? It should be 28. So 28 should be the final answer. Right. 28 should be the final answer. I hope it is correct. Right. To everyone it is correct. I hope. No doubt. Absolutely. Same question goes. Right. Same question goes. I'll just rub it here for you. And same question goes if it is 27. If the question I make it 27 now. Okay, if I make it 27 here, look at it, 27 now. So I know that rules for 37 and 27 are same, right? Rules for 37 and 27 are same because 10 cube by 27 also will give me a remainder of plus 1, will give me a remainder of plus 1, right? 10 cube by 10 raised to 3k by 27 will give me a remainder of always plus 1, okay? So it's always 27. It's always 27. Same thing will go. Just I'll replace by 27. Right. So just answer will change. Nothing is. Answer will change. Nothing is. Right. 27. 27. Right. So again, rule is same for 27 also. So 10 cube by 27 will give me a remainder of plus 1. Okay. So again, same thing. Make groups of 3-3. Okay. 74,100 by 27. So 7174. Right, so this is how much? So 174 by 27. 27. 27 into 6 is 162. What is the answer? Answer is 12 in this case. Answer is 12 in this case. Okay, this is for 27. Right, so last question was for 37. This is for 27. The rules for 37 and 27 both are same, right? Because both 10 cube by 37 also gives me a remainder of plus 1. So I'll make groups of 3-3 there. And 10 cube by 27 also gives me a remainder of plus 1. So again, I'll make a group of 3-3 there, right? So rules are same for both the cases. Okay? Now, next concept we'll discuss in next video. Thank you. Do watch it again. It's a very important concept. Again and again, do watch it. Okay. Thank you.